متعدي. There's a very interesting history. Very interesting history of Islam here in America. I was just thinking on the way to Hagerstown, Sheikh Adli, from the Haram to Hagerstown. From the Haram, where the Kaaba stands, to Hagerstown, a place that has supported the da'wah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala since its inception, mashallah. And we pray that it continues to the Day of Judgment. I had the opportunity to be here last week. And I actually spoke with a young youth, one of the youth. And one of the brothers came up and said, SubhanAllah, I saw a picture with this Sheikh Adli. I've seen him before, and you know, I have always wanted to go from Hagerstown to South Carolina. I'm like, SubhanAllah. So much, and that brother is Brother Muhammad here. I mean, mashallah, so Brother Muhammad has met the Sheikh, mashallah. And then now the Sheikh is here in Hagerstown by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'd like to thank the board for coordinating all of this, alhamdulillah. May Allah give them the reward for this, for bringing the scholars and the ulama to the masajid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sheikh Adli is with us on the Al-Huda School tour prior to Sunday's dinner, inshallah. He has had the opportunity to visit the PGMA community. He gave the khutbah at Dar es Salaam today. We wanted to include our dear brothers and sisters here in Hagerstown, even though it's very far, subhanAllah, coming over the mountains. And we were thinking, who would think in that land, you know, coming over the hills, that there would be so many Muslims from different places? No one would even think that we would be here sitting. And the topic tonight, inshallah, that we're going to, the Sheikh is going to be discussing, is this deep topic. This deep topic of certainty, of trust in Allah, of yaqeen, the concept of the belief in the unseen, the concept that Allah is with us if we're doing the right thing. It doesn't matter what happens in our lives, if we are doing the right thing and we are following our deen, because our deen is the truth and we've been blessed with this, Allah is with us. Tonight, I'd like to welcome Sheikh Adli. He will be speaking on ilm al-yaqeen and the concept of yaqeen in general. And then, Dr. Wahid was saying, inshallah, we would love to give him time, inshallah, for feedback and questions regarding the concept of yaqeen, inshallah, after the short bayan, inshallah. Put this on. Thank you, Sheikh.
Inna alhamdulillah. نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance, and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge in Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. and whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the guidance of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah and don't die unless you are in the state of Islam. After this, I greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. And I want to tell you one thing, that I was so excited to be here. I went east, south, north, west, England, Guyana, Belize, name it. But one place I didn't come here, and what's happening, that Brother Omar, may Allah reward him, he was talking to me too much about the community here. So I start so excited and almost telling him, can you speed a little bit more so I can go see this community? Subhanallah. And one thing I see unique right away, that we have the younger children here. This is a good sign, my brothers and my sister. May Allah reward you. May Allah bless you and bless your families. Because me and you, or at least me, we one hand span almost to the grave. But the future of Islam is with this new generation. So may Allah reward you. How many families or how many brothers or sisters, they go to the mosque. But where is the children back home watching the devil box? I don't know if you heard this term before or not. Means TV, DV, okay, devil box. Or that they bring the children, but they bring the children to the mosque and they are playing basketball or Nintendo or whatever someplace else. So right away I got to see something that pleases me and make me so happy, and I make dua for you as well as all the Muslims. May Allah bless you all. This is something so good. I've been given 20 minutes and already 5 minutes and 16 seconds is gone. So inshallah, let me come with one hadith and after this we'll close. Because if I start a subject, maybe you will be here for tahajjud. And I don't want to do this from the first visit. But inshallah, I have about at least 1400 segments on YouTube. So you can, if you like the product, you can go and listen. But one thing, by the way, although that you have a lot of things good, one thing will surprise me. Guess what it is? I didn't see any of my books here. And this shocked me. Because I've been working hard, okay, for the last 10 years at least, making sure at least my book, Salah and Termites, reach everywhere in America. But I came here between the mountains. The book of Salah is not here, neither the book of Termites.
We were waiting that you will bring the book.
I used to carry books when I used to travel, when I used to be a young man. I have a small car, 2-3 boxes, 30 pounds each, 32 pounds, and from airport to airport, and they drop these books and go. But now, alhamdulillah, I got old. I'm 63 years old now. Plus, alhamdulillah, I have a desk, okay? And so I stopped traveling. But just now, may Allah bless my doctor and all the doctors. He gave me 4 shots last week in my back. So this is my first trip to come. So But somebody say, but brother, why are you talking to us about Book of Salah? We've been making Salah before even you born. I agree. But like I said in my khutbah today, in the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not today, not we born Muslim, no, in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and I'm sure all of you know this story. There is a man came and make Salah. And after this, Assalamu alaikum, O Messenger of Allah. Say, Wa alaikum assalam. And what he said to him? Ud fasalli fa innaka lam tusalli. Go back and make your salah over. Because he didn't pray. The man went and pray again. And he came to greet the Prophet. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, Wa alaikum assalam. Go back and make your salah over because he didn't pray. 3 times. Can you imagine this? Finally, he said, I swear by the one who sent you the truth. I don't know better. Teach me, O Prophet of Allah. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught him. So alhamdulillah, in a small booklet, I did my best with the tawfiq of Allah and made this book, and now is the 7th edition just came out. So Muslims or new Muslim, new Shahada born Muslim, they should read this book. The second book called Termites. What is termites? I'm not coming here, I'm not going to be Omar too. I don't make publicity, I'm not coming to commercialize anything here. But it happens that I didn't find my book here because it's good that he say about what he see good. And see also about what he didn't see. Maybe one day you will see it there. I made a book, I call it Termite. And a lot of people, when they used to see the book, they keep walking. Because I'm a Muslim, what I need to do with termites? So some people were surprised what it is. So the 2nd edition, I put another note under the title. So the people to understand, this is not for you to learn how to be exterminator. You are not going to go for houses to house and the roach spray and all these things. This termites mean the termites is this ants or this insect that eats the foundation, eats the wood. And after this, the whole house can collapse. So the termites is a cancer of doing good deed, but there is something else there, it will destroy the good deed. This is very dangerous. And inshallah, I will promise each one of you a copy if you want. It's free. So you don't think I'm coming to sell my books here. Okay? I'm not in book business. I'm in da'wah business. Alhamdulillah. So please allow me to send to you my book, Termites. And kindly, please try to read it. I wrote about few issues there. That common Muslims, born and raised Muslims, they do it. But there is something else, they doing it also, it will destroy what they did from good deed. And just to give you an example about this man who's making salah fast and quick. The Prophet, when he taught him, said, ثُمَّ ارْكَعْ حَتَّى تَطْمَئِنَّ رَاكِعَ. Then bow down and take your time until you be comfortable in your position of bowing down, then rise up. ثُمَّ اطْمَئِنْ حَتَّى تَطْمَئِنْ. My brothers and sisters, if you swinging up and down like this, your bones, each mufsal and each joint doesn't go back in its right place, forget about this salah. Okay? So the unique thing the Prophet told this man is what? حتى تطمئن راكعا حتى تطمئن ساجدا. Take your time when you make a sujood. Don't Allah. This is not a salah. It doesn't work like this. And they say that a scholar saw a man was praying in this fashion. He said, come son, come here. He said, how long you been praying like this? He said, for the last 20 years. He said he didn't pray for the last 20 years. So this, I call it termites. That you're doing good deed, but there is something there is destroying the good deed. So it is good to do a good deed, but it is very important to protect your good deed. Still a small introduction, and we lost another 8 minutes. It's not a loss. Hopefully, you got something out of it. Let me get you one hadith, inshallah, be out, especially that I heard that you have some questions. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying what the meaning is. المؤمن القوي خير وأحب إلى الله من المؤمن الضعيف وفي كل خير احرص على ما ينفعك واستعن بالله ولا تعجز وإن أصابك شيء فقل فلا تقل لو أني فعلت كذا لكان كذا ولكن قل قدر الله وما شاء فعل فإن لو تفتح عمل الشيطان. Okay? What's the hadith is saying? Number one, المؤمن القوي خير وأحب إلى الله. المؤمن, the believers, the one who adopt faith. Okay? And for the shortage of time, I'm going to try to go fast on the hadith. But you know what is a mu'min? Like a Muslim, a person who adopted Islam became a Muslim. And a person who believe in articles of faith became a mu'min, believers. Okay? And a person who fast, you call him sa'im, sawm and siyam, Muslim, Islam, okay? Mu'min, iman. And a person who acts in uhsan, you say he's a muhsin. Alright? So the believer, al-mu'min, al-qawi. The Prophet says the strong believer is more dearer to Allah and more good. So there is two types of believers, and you can be one of them. You can be a strong believer or you can be a weak believer. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves the stronger one. So we believe in Allah, we believe also in the attributes of Allah, and one of the attributes and qualities of Allah that Allah loves, there is certain things that Allah loves it. And when we, me and you, try to do what Allah loves, Allah will love us. And what some of the things that Allah loves, أحب البقاع إلى الله المساجد, out of the land, out of the earth, the most dearest spots to Allah is the masajid. You see? And do you know what is the worst? The marketplaces. Exactly. Here is the remembrance of Allah. They're forgetting almost the remembrance of Allah. How much and how what about this? What about you give me for five? I give you with it. It's no time about subhanallah, alhamdulillah. Some of the sahaba, may Allah be pleased with them, they used to go specially to the market to remember Allah there. His companion said, what? I see you always going to the market. You go, you come back, I didn't see you buying something. You don't have money, what's it? He said, I go there to remember Allah because the reward is more rewarded, because everybody is busy with the dunya. So I go there where is the heedless places there, so I remember Allah there. So there is certain actions, certain places, certain things Allah love it. And we have to search, and this is a different subject also, we can talk about what does Allah love, and whom that Allah loves, and how we can love Allah, and how Allah will love us. This is a big other talk, it need another talk by itself. But المؤمن القوي خير, better, وأحب إلى الله, and more dearer to Allah. So me and you have to try to see, what does it make me, not only a believer, but a strong believer. Nevertheless, you are better and more dearer to Allah than the weak believer. Okay? But the Prophet ﷺ saying what? وَفِي كُلٍ خَيْرٍ. In both are goodness. Because iman, it makes you to be good. That means Allah loves more the strong believer. What about the weak believer? Still, there is good in him because he's a believer. He still a believer, believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing in all the unseen, believing in the angels, believing in Yawm al-Qiyamah, resurrection after death, believing in all the prophets, in all the messages of Allah, and all the messages. So it's still good in him. So the opposite of good is bad. And a believer never can be bad. Regardless whatever, he's still a good. He's still good. You know when you be bad? When you are not a Muslim. And Allah even said, إِنَّمَا الْمُشْرِكُونَ نَجَسْ. Indeed, the mushrikun are impure. Okay? One day, Abu Huraira, radiallahu anhu, he saw the Prophet, so he took another road and hide it. Later on, Abu Huraira, when he say, Abu Huraira, what happened? I spot you, I saw you. What's happened? He said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I was impure. He said that I was in najasa, in impurity. I didn't take shower after, you understand, a relation, intimate relationship. So I didn't take, so I'm impure. He said, Subhanallah, Inna al-mu'min la yanjus. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, glory to Allah. Never the believer can be impure. So regardless how good or you call it bad, we don't use bad, how strong you are in your faith or how weak you are in faith, you still, there is something good in you. So it's for you to promote this weakness and you bring it up. Bring this iman up so you can be more dearer to Allah. But regardless, the Prophet ﷺ said, وَفِي كُلِّنْ خَيْرٍ. Both believers, there is khair in them. Always the khair, always the good in the hearts of the believers. Okay? وَفِي كُلِّنْ خَيْرٍ. Then the Prophet ﷺ saying what? إِحْرِسْ عَلَى مَا يَنْفَعَكْ وَاسْتَعِمْ بِاللَّهِ. Number one, إِحْرِسْ. Be concerned. Go after. ما ينفعك من النفع, okay? Something beneficial for you, go after it. Be concerned about it. A good bargain, okay, go ahead. Good bargain. But don't be spendthrift, okay? Hey, husband, why, dear honey, مشعر, okay, give me your credit card. Why, honey? Say, oh, it's a big discount. 25%. But do we need it? No. And we're going to go buy and shopping and after this in the closet. The closet is full. Now the attic is full. And after this, oh, we have too much stuff in there. Let's take it out. And you understand, give it to the Salvation Army. Know that if there is something beneficial, then go after it. Okay? Go after it. Yeah, I see I can get this car, you understand, it's a good deal for 3,000. Inshallah, I'm going to put it in the Carolina Trader or whatever. I'll put 500 and make a profit. It's fine, okay? There is nothing wrong, okay? فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةِ فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ. Nothing haram. As long as you do it halal business, it's fine, okay? Anything you find it is beneficial for you, getting degree, be specializing in something, okay? Whatever it is that you see it, as long as it's not contradicting the deen of Allah, that see it is going to benefit you in the dunya or in the hereafter, go after it. Go after it. Okay? احرس على ما ينفعك. But what? واستعن بالله ولا تعجز. Always seek help in Allah. Don't think it's your mighty, it's your power. But always seeking help in Allah. Always rely in Allah. And always see your weakness and humble yourself before Allah. Is not my power, is not how smart I am, but always إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدْ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدْ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. We're ready, we're going to worship, but we need your help, Allah. We need your assistance, Ya Allah, about your food, about your family, about your children, raising them. This is a big jihad, okay? And this is like salah. This is ibadah, raising the children properly, is a form of ibadah. Because Allah saying in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا All you believe, save yourself and your children from hellfire. So for me, you understand, احرص على ما ينفعك. And this one of the main things. Yeah, after I die, I could not pray. I could not fast. Is this true, Hamad? It's true? Can you pray after you die? After I die, forget about it. Don't worry, okay? It's still too young. After I die, can I fast? Can I give lectures? So now I have to be smart. What I do? Say, yes, I want after I die, I still get the blessing. So now I go get with my phone, and when I give any talk, record it, put it in YouTube, Google, put it in the internet, somebody else will benefit. I can be dead in my grave, and somebody listens the lecture, learning something, now I'm benefiting. Now, أحرص على ما ينفعك, my children, after I die. Because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إذا مات ابن آدم انقطع عمله إلا من ثلاث. When son of Adam die, all his good deed or her good deed is what? Is sealed, is ended, with exception of three things. One of them is what? A ولد صالح يدعو له. So now I'm going to say, my boy or my girl is going to be beneficial for me, special after I die. If I raise them to be a good Muslim, they know the way to the mosque, they know the verses, book of Allah, they making their salah, they doing their hijab, they listening to the, all these things. So now, after my death, my child will say, رب اغفر لي ولوالدي رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. So anything that can beneficial for you in the dunya or for the hereafter, go after it, but seek help in Allah. ولا تعجز. Don't be defeated. Okay? A Muslim go after what is right and what is halal with seeking the help of Allah and all hope in Allah and all trust in Allah, all the yaqeen in Allah that Allah will give it to him. But sometimes it doesn't happen, is it? I did my best. I try. I want him to be a doctor. He didn't become a doctor. I kept trying to make him a hafiz. He not a hafiz. I tried to teach. You did your best. Okay? So now, فإن أصابك شيء فلا تقل لو أني فعلت كذا لكان كذا. Okay? Now, after you did your best, and you was concerned, and you seek help in Allah, but it didn't work. Sometimes, understand, said a good bargain. This, I will be millionaire. A good business, investment. Go for it. Partnership. One, two, three people, everybody understand, $500,000, buy it, and after this, economics went down. So now we could not even get our capital, our original investment. Say, don't. Now misfortune happened to you. So what you supposed to be? He said, فَإِنْ أَصَابَكَ شَيْءٍ. When something befallen in you, calamity, it didn't go according to your expectation, do not say if I listened to his advice, I didn't lose my money. If you understand, I drove the other way, you understand it's going to be a car accident.